opportunity to witness amazing talents today. I am going to speak about the source of these talents, probably the last talk a professor speaking about education. I bet you that I'm going to share you something useful. So I'm going to speak about my experience with education. I'm going to share my story in three phases of my life: student, college, and my profession. During schooling days, I used to spend 8 to 10 hours with books without knowing the purpose. I used to carry heavy loads of books, trying to gather knowledge from them. Spend most of the time within four walls. Being from a lower middle class family, my parents always felt education is the only tool by which we can become financially reliant. I remember those days when I missed a school excursion because of financial problems, and a letter written by, explanation letter written by my half-literate uncle was made fun in the class. I think most of the millennials would connect with me, even though I don't find much difference in the present day of education. The only preference is given to grades. Less importance is given to the real life skills like strategic management, financial management, stress management, or teamwork and communication skills. The only sense of the real world I had was during the playtime on a Sunday evening, or when I used to visit my grandfather or grandparents, and my grandfather used to ask me common sense questions. Second phase, college. During college days, I had to stay away from my home. It was a real struggle for me because I was lagging real life skills. I felt I was losing race with education. I had the appetite of learning something new, but loads of courses, no one to teach, was a problem. I had a habit of reading from the first page of the textbook because understanding the root cause of the concept gave me pleasure in learning. But of course, this made me lag in grades. This is when I seriously started thinking, what is the purpose of my life? What is the purpose of education? Then I have to resort to motivational books, self-help books. This is where I was inspired by the quotations of Swami Vivekananda. Swami Vivekananda, quote, take up an idea, make that idea your life, breathe on the right idea, think about that idea, and live on that idea, unquote. Education is the manifestation of perfection already existing in man. Now, these ideas have made me to think, what is the bigger purpose of my life? Now, I've decided somehow at that age, I had patriotic feelings develop because of my growth or because of the reason that my education was sponsored by government. I've decided that my education should contribute some value to the society around me. And this I've decided as a purpose of my life. But having a bigger purpose and very low in confidence because my education always have shown me inferior. The third phase of my life is profession. I've taken up teaching as profession. To be really frank, that was the only option initially I had. But when I've started teaching, I have got immense satisfaction. Training next generation was immense satisfaction for me. The good thing about teaching is that you get instantaneous feedback and get satisfied about it. Wherever I go, I would attract the best talent when I teach. Probably my asset of reading from the first page and understanding the root cause has given me this benefit. And also my voice, of course, has helped me. Now, going ahead, I was colorful with my profession, doing excellent job in my profession. But slowly, I felt that I'm moving away from the purpose of my life. I wanted my education to contribute something to society around. I was moving away from it because being a university professor, we always solve problems from research papers or we educate students. And these students take up jobs or move to abroad or take up jobs in MNCs. So I was feeling that I was moving away from my vision of life. Now, slowly I started analyzing, what is the problem, where is the problem? Now, I could figure out a problem that the classrooms and the real world run in silos. The one thing which we feel that education is the one which brings a change in the society, but the society and classrooms run in silos. Now, how do we figure it out? How do we change it? I started thinking over it day and night. I found that because I'm from engineering background, I found that I have to solve this. I thought a new branch of program need to be started, something called product-based engineering, where a student in the first year of engineering should be sent into society or industry, identify a potential problem, and then align all the curriculum or the course structure in discussion with the faculty to solve that problem to a product or a service. This was lingering in my mind, but I don't know how to do it, how to get it done. This is when I was introduced to a wonderful tool called design thinking and innovation. This is a problem-solving tool which relies on the cornerstone empathy. Empathy is getting into the shoes of someone and understanding their pain points. This is used generally by corporates to understand the user requirements, take them to industry and develop a product as per the requirements. I felt it was a magical tool. Why can't we use it in education system? Of course, many developed countries are doing it. Why can't we use it for our contextual problem solving? Now, this is where I felt like this design thinking need to be brought into every form of education. A student should be made to get empathized with the society around, try to understand the unmet needs of the people and the system, and these unmet needs are to be brought into the classroom. And if these unmet needs are worked out in student teams, innovative solutions would come up. A kid working in a school or studying in a school will get a connect with the society, will get an association with the society rather than feeling isolated in the classroom. This tool can bring the real world into classroom. This tool can make students equipped with real-world problem-solving skills. So if the problem is owned by the kid, if the problem is owned by the student, then the learning happens autonomous. This is what I feel. Learning happens autonomous. So now, if this tool is employed in schools, colleges, and universities, they become the source of innovation. They can train a confident generation to make the vision of making India possible. This is what I felt. We have implemented this tool for the last 3 years in our university, and we are getting amazing results. Students take up varieties of problems like heavy rush in the canteens during the peak hours, the break times, how to solve that problem, how to clean the water bodies by using robotics, how to use drones for agriculture, how to use drones for rescue, what not. If I give the problem to students, they come up with amazing problems and they work out in teams with amazing solutions and they enjoy the process. This is what I felt was amazing. So this tool majorly relies on imbibing EQ with the same time, at the same level as IQ, emotional coefficient at the same level as intelligent coefficient. Our present education system needs a paradigm shift because most focus is on IQ. Only intelligent coefficient is being developed. What about EQ? You know, the tools, AI tools like ChatGPT are coming up. The effect of those tools are going to do all the IQ job, right? Human beings will be left with the EQ job. So it is the need of the hour for this paradigm shift that education system should imbibe this EQ into the kids or students. This tool makes the youth equipped with the skill, right, of viewing or mindset of viewing the problem as an opportunity. Problem as an opportunity and convert this opportunity into a product and become an entrepreneur. Or they can use this innovative solutions in every walk of life. Developing innovative solutions are required in every profession. So using design thinking in my classroom as a teacher has given me immense satisfaction in my profession, in reaching my purpose of life, that is making a change in my surrounding society. Hope this would be used by all the educators and all the students who are pursuing education. Thanks for the opportunity. Thank you.